students, welcome to my channel Learning History Made Easy. In today's video, I will be explaining about the rise of Marathas. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel for the first time, or if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and share it with your friends. So without wasting time, let us get into the video. So today's video, we are going to see about the rise of Marathas. So today's topic is rise of Marathas. So the decline of the Mughals led to the rise of independent states in different part of India. So till the last chapter we were learning about Mughals, and now with the decline of Mughals, that is the end of Mughal power or Mughal dynasty, what happened was it saw the rise of independent states in different part of India. So after the decline of Mughals, many independent states started rising in different parts of India. Okay, many independent states started coming. And one of the most prominent among such independent states was Marathas. So one of the most prominent independent states which came after the decline of the Mughals were Marathas. And the founder of Maratha kingdom was Shivaji. So Shivaji was the founder of Maratha kingdom. So with the decline of Mughals, many independent states came in different parts of India, and one of the most prominent among them was Marathas, and the founder of Marathas was Shivaji. Now here the most important topic for you to learn is about Shivaji. So let us see point by point the important points regarding Shivaji. So the first point already we have learned, Shivaji was the founder of Marathas. Shivaji was the founder of Marathas. Now the birthplace of Shivaji, Shivaji was born at Shivaneri. So he was born at Shivaneri, and he was born in 1627 century era. So Shivaji was born in Shivaneri at 1627 century era. And Shivaji's parents were Shahaji Bonsle and Jijabai. The parents' father's name was Shahaji Bonsle and mother was Jijabai. So Shivaji's parents were Shahaji Bonsle and Jijabai. Now Shahaji, that is Shivaji's father, he served under the Sultan of Ahmednagar and later under Adil Shah. So that is, his father was a general in army. Shivaji's father was a general in army. And he served under two major powers, that is, he worked under Sultan of Ahmednagar, and he also worked under Adil Shahis of Bijapura. So Adil Shahis also, under both these kings, Shivaji's father worked as a general in army. First he was under Sultan of Ahmednagar, later he was working under Adil Shahis of Bijapura as the general in army. So Shivaji was the founder of Marathas. He was born in Shivaneri in 1627 century era. Parents of Shivaji were Shahaji Bonsle and Jijabai. And Shivaji's father was a general in army. He worked under Sultan of Ahmednagar and Adil Shahis of Bijapura. Now let us see further points about Shivaji. Now Shivaji's father, that is Shahaji Bonsle, I am writing Shahaji, he was granted the Jagir of Pune. So when that time, as salary, they were given Jagirs or land. So Shahaji was granted the Jagir of Pune. So the as a reward or as a payment, Shivaji's father was given the Jagir of Pune, and this Jagir was looked after by his mother Jijabai. It was looked after by Jijabai. Why? Because Shivaji's father was in another Jagir granted to him. So Shivaji's father did not have the time to look after this Jagir of Pune. So it was looked after by his mother Jijabai. So now Jijabai was a very courageous lady and of a pious temperament. So Jijabai was a great influencer in the life of Shivaji, Shivaji's mother. She was a lady of courage. She was a very courageous lady, but together with that, she was of a very pious temperament. She was having a very pious temperament also. Okay, so that was how, that was the character of Shivaji's mother. She was a very courageous lady. Together with that, she was having a very pious temperament. Now, Shivaji influenced all these characters in her son. That is, Jijabai influenced all these characters in her son. So now Shivaji had all good characters like heroism, and together with heroism, he was very spiritual. That is very religious or godly, and he was also very chivalrous. That is, he was very courageous. So Shivaji got all the good characters from his mother, or his mother infused all these good characters in her son. That is heroism, spirituality, and chivalry. So Shivaji grew up in such a situation, and it is said that Jijabai used to narrate stories from epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata to Shivaji. Ramayana and Mahabharata. So these stories Shivaji's mother used to narrate to Shivaji, and that made Shivaji even more courageous. The stories from Ramayana and Mahabharata made Shivaji even more courageous. So Shahaji was given Jagir of Pune, and it was looked after by his wife or Shivaji's mother, Jijabai. Jijabai was a lady of courage and a pious temperament, and Jijabai infused all these characters in her son, like heroism, spirituality, and chivalry. She used to narrate stories from Ramayana and Mahabharata to Shivaji, and these made him even more courageous. So that was how Shivaji's character developed, and especially because of the influence of his mother. Not only his mother, he also had a tutor and guide. First influencer was his mother, then Shivaji had a tutor and guide. The tutor's name was Dadaji Kondadeva. So Shivaji's tutor and guide's name was Dadaji Kondadeva. Dadaji Kondadeva trained Shivaji in the art of administration and warfare. So everything about administration and warfare, both these things were taught to Shivaji by Dadaji Kondadeva. So he taught everything to Shivaji about administration and warfare. Now, other than his mother and other than his tutor and guide, Shivaji was also influenced by saints like Ram Das and Tukaram. Saints like Ram Das and Tukaram also influenced Shivaji, because we have already told that Shivaji had a character of spiritualism also. So these saints also influenced him. That is, Ram Das and Tukaram also influenced Shivaji. And the Mavallis are a tribe living in the hilly tracts, became his friends and followers. These Mavallis lived in the hilly tracts, and they became very influenced by Shivaji, and they became Shivaji's friends and followers. Now, why I am saying this point here is, later we will see how Mavallis helped Shivaji in some situations. So his mother influenced Shivaji. Other than that, he had a tutor and a guide called as Dadaji Kondadeva, who trained Shivaji in administration and warfare. Other than that, Shivaji was influenced by saints like Ram Das and Tukaram. The Mavallis, who lived in the hilly tracts, became his friends and followers. So these were about the early life of Shivaji. Now let us just see the points till now. Whatever we have learned, just let us revise. So we have studied the introduction, that is Rise of Marathas, The decline of Mughals led to the rise of independent states in different parts of India. Marathas were prominent among them. Shivaji was the founder of Maratha kingdom. Now about Shivaji, he was born at Shivaneri in 1627 century era. His parents were Shahaji Bonsle and Jijabai. Shahaji served under the Sultan of Ahmednagar and later the Adil Shahis of Bijapura as a general in army. He had been granted the Jagir of Pune and it was looked after by Jijabai. Jijabai was a lady of courage and pious temperament. She infused in her son heroism, spiritualism and chivalry. The stories from the epics of Ramayana and Mahabharata made Shivaji more courageous. The tutor and guide of Shivaji was Dadaji Kondadeva. He trained Shivaji in the art of administration and warfare. He was also influenced by saints like Ramdas and Tukaram. Mawallis living in the hilly tracts became his friends and followers. So this much points we have seen till now. So next we are going to see about the achievements of Shivaji. So the next point is the achievements of Shivaji. So what were his achievements, or how did he conquer places? Which all places did he conquer? So here achievements, mainly we are going to see his conquest. Now Shivaji entered into military career even before the age of 20. So he entered into military career at a very young age, that is even before the age of 20 years. Okay, so before the age of 20 years only he entered military career, and the first place which he conquered was he conquered the fort of Torana. And who helped him to conquer this fort of Torana? That is Mawallis. So when I told you about Mawallis, I have told you I will explain how Mawallis helped Shivaji. So they were actually a kind of tribal people. They became friends of Shivaji and they helped him in conquering the fort of Torana. After that, he also conquered many forts like the fort of Chakana, the fort of Kondana, the fort of Purandara. All these forts he conquered. These forts were conquered from all these forts Shivaji conquered, and they were conquered from Adil Shahis of Bijapura. So now here was the problem. We all have studied that Shivaji's father was working under Adil Shahis. That is, Shahaji Bonsle, Shivaji's father, was working as a general in the army under Adil Shahis. Now Shivaji conquered all these forts from the Adil Shahis, that is Chakana, Kondana, Purandara. All these forts were conquered from Adil Shahis. Naturally, the Adil Shahi Sultan became very upset, and what he did, the Sultan of Bijapur imprisoned Shahaji. So Shahaji, that is Shivaji's father, was imprisoned. He was put in jail. Why? Because his son had conquered all these places from Adil Shahis. Okay, so once more, Shivaji entered military career before the age of 20. He first conquered the fort of Torana with the help of Mawallis. Later he conquered the forts of Chakana, Kondana, Purandara, etc. from the Adil Shahis of Bijapura. Shivaji's father Shahaji was working under Adil Shahis, and Sultan of Bijapur imprisoned Shahaji. That is, Shivaji's father was imprisoned. Now what happened after this? Shivaji was a very intelligent person. So Shivaji, through his diplomatic intelligence, got the release of his father. So Shivaji was very intelligent, and through his diplomatic intelligence, so he somehow managed to convince the king of Bijapura. He somehow released his father. So Shahaji was released from the jail. Shivaji somehow with his diplomatic intelligence somehow he convinced the king and got the release of his father. And now later Shivaji turned his attention to Konkan coast. Now Shivaji thought he will go to conquer Konkan coast, and here he occupied the region of Javali. Okay, Javali region. So he conquered, for the time being he started to concentrate on Konkan coast and he conquered Javali region. So that region of Konkan coast was captured by Shivaji, and what he did there, he built a new fort. Shivaji here constructed a new fort. That fort was called as Pratapagada. Pratapagada fort was constructed here. Okay, so Shivaji through his diplomatic intelligence somehow released his father from jail, and later he turned his attention towards Konkan coast, and there he conquered the Javali region and he built a new fort there, that is a fort of Pratapagada. So that was the first set of a conquest done by Shivaji. Now let us see the next conquest of Shivaji, that is Shivaji and Afzal Khan. Shivaji and Afzal Khan. So what is the relationship between Shivaji and Afzal Khan? Who is Afzal Khan? Let us see this. Shivaji's activities against Adil Shahi is continued. So Shivaji activities against Adil Shahi's continued. So we already saw that first Shivaji conquered many forts under Adil Shahi's. His father was put in prison. Again somehow he released his father, and for the time being he did not conquer places, but later he continued his activities against Adil Shahi's. So naturally the Sultan of Adil Shahi, Sultan of Bijapur, did not like it. So what Sultan of Bijapur thought? Sultan of Bijapur thought that somehow I have to punish Shivaji. So Sultan of Bijapur wanted to punish Shivaji because his father is working under him and he is conquering the places. So he wanted to punish Shivaji, and in order to punish Shivaji, Sultan of Bijapur sent a person. That person's name is Afzal Khan. So Afzal Khan was sent by the Sultan of Bijapur. Why? To punish Shivaji. But Shivaji, you know how intelligent Shivaji is. Shivaji very tactfully, or with a lot of intelligence, he killed Afzal Khan. So Shivaji finally killed Afzal Khan, and even after killing Afzal Khan, Shivaji also looted his camp. Afzal Khan's camp was also looted by Shivaji. He killed Afzal Khan. And finally, Sultan of Bijapur understood that it is not possible to fight against Shivaji. So what Sultan of Bijapur did? Sultan of Bijapur made peace with Shivaji. That is, made peace with Shivaji. That is, he compromised with Shivaji because there was no other way. Sultan of Bijapur made peace with Shivaji and recognized all his conquest. So Shivaji and Afzal Khan, Shivaji continued his activities against Adil Shahis, and Sultan of Bijapur wanted to punish Shivaji. So in order to punish Shivaji, he sent a person. That person is Afzal Khan. But Shivaji very tactfully killed Afzal Khan and looted his camp, and the Sultan of Bijapur finally in 1661 century era, he made peace with Shivaji and recognized his conquest. So that is about Shivaji and Afzal Khan. Now let us see about Shivaji and Aurangzeb, the relation between Shivaji and Aurangzeb. Okay, Shivaji and Aurangzeb. So Shivaji, as usual, he conquered many places and forts belonging to Aurangzeb. So he conquered many territories and forts belonging to Aurangzeb. So that was done by Shiva, because Shivaji is conquering more and more places. And Aurangzeb, upset with this, appointed a person against Shivaji. Like the Sultan of Bijapur appointed Afzal Khan, same like that, Aurangzeb appointed a person called as Shaista Khan to fight against Shivaji. So Shaista Khan against Shivaji. So this was the person appointed by Aurangzeb to fight against or to check the expansion of Shivaji. Shaista Khan was very powerful and he succeeded in occupying a vast Maratha territory including Pune. So Shaista Khan, he was successful in controlling Shivaji, that is, he was successful in occupying a vast Maratha territory. So a lot of areas from the Maratha territory means Shivaji's territory, he occupied a lot of areas. He was successful in occupying vast Maratha territory including Pune. So Pune also was occupied by Shaista Khan. You know about Pune, it was the Jagir given to Shivaji's father Shahaji. And Pune was looked after by Shivaji's mother Jijabai. Already in the beginning we have studied that. So including Pune, a lot of Maratha territory was occupied by Shaista Khan. So Shivaji and Aurangzeb, Shivaji conquered many territories and forts belonging to Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb appointed a person called as Shaista Khan to check the movement of Shivaji against Shivaji. Shaista Khan was successful in occupying a vast territory belonging to Marathas including Pune. So what happened now? Let us see. How did Shivaji manage this? So after conquering Pune, Shaista Khan stayed in the house where Shivaji had spent his childhood. So Shaista Khan, he conquered a lot of Maratha kingdom, and what he did was he stayed in a house at Pune where Shivaji had spent his childhood. Okay, so Shivaji spent his childhood in that house, and that place was conquered, and now Shaista Khan was staying in that. So naturally Shivaji had an emotional attachment towards that house. So what Shivaji did, Shivaji somehow wanted to reconquer that. So in 1663, Shivaji entered the city of Pune. So he entered the city of Pune. He had some of his soldiers also, with a few hundred soldiers, and they did not enter directly. It is said that they disguised themselves as a marriage party. Okay, they dressed themselves as going for a marriage party, and there was a function happening in that house, and they directly entered the house in the disguise as a marriage party. Okay, they entered the house and immediately Shivaji attacked Shaista Khan. So attacked Shaista Khan. Shaista Khan also fought bravely, and it is said that Shaista Khan lost his fingers in the fight. He lost his fingers, but he escaped with his life. So he lost his fingers, but escaped from Shivaji. Shivaji was not able to kill Shaista Khan. He escaped with his life. So Shaista Khan was successful in occupying a vast Maratha territory including Pune. Shaista Khan stayed in a house in Pune where Shivaji had spent his childhood. Now Shivaji wanted to reconquer that place. Shivaji in 1663 entered the city of Pune with his soldiers disguised as a marriage party. They entered the house and immediately attacked Shaista Khan. Shaista Khan lost his fingers, but he escaped with his life, and this increased the fame of Shivaji. Now Shivaji became very famous because he recaptured the territories which was conquered. So that was about Shivaji and Aurangzeb. So now let us just see the points which we have studied till now. achievements of Shivaji, conquest. Shivaji entered into military career even before the age of 20. He captured the fort of Torana with the help of Mavalis. He also captured many other forts like Chakana, Kondana, Purandara, etc. from Adilshahis of Bijapur. The Sultan of Bijapur imprisoned Shahaji, Shivaji's father. But Shivaji, through his diplomatic intelligence, got the release of his father. Later, Shivaji turned his attention to Konkan coast and occupied the region of Chavali. He built the new fort Pratapagada here. Now Shivaji and Afzal Khan. Shivaji's activities against Adil Shahis continued. The Sultan of Bijapur wanted to punish Shivaji and sent Afzal Khan against him. Shivaji very tactfully killed Afzal Khan and looted his camp. In 1661 century era, the Sultan of Bijapur made peace with Shivaji and recognized his conquest. Now Shivaji and Aurangzeb. Shivaji conquered many territories and forts belonging to Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb appointed Shaista Khan to check the expansion of Shivaji. Shaista Khan succeeded in occupying a vast Maratha territory including Pune. Shaista Khan stayed in the house where Shivaji had spent his childhood. In 1663, Shivaji entered the city of Pune with a few hundred soldiers disguised as a marriage party. They entered the house and Shivaji attacked Shaista Khan. Khan lost his fingers but escaped with his life, and this increased the fame of Shivaji. So that was about Shivaji and Aurangzeb. Now next let us see about Shivaji's attack on Surat. So his conquest is continuing. So the next is attack on Surat. Okay. So in 1664 century era, Shivaji attacked and plundered Surat. So Shivaji in 1664 attacked and plundered Surat. It was a very rich port. Surat was a very rich port, and that is because of that Shivaji was able to collect almost 1 crore rupees from there. So after conquering the area, he was able to collect almost 1 crore rupees. The English who supported the Mughals were beaten back. So the English were supporting the Mughals, and when they saw the expansion of Shivaji, they were beaten back. But when Shivaji heard the arrival of Mughal force, he fled from Surat. So Shivaji heard that the Mughals are coming to Surat. So when Shivaji heard the arrival of Mughals, what did Shivaji do? He fled from there. He went away from Surat. Now what happened? Aurangzeb sent another person, that is Raja Jai Singh, against Shivaji. So now the next person was sent by Aurangzeb against Shivaji. So Aurangzeb sent Raja Jai Singh. This is the next person who come to fight against Shivaji. So he sent Raja Jai Singh against Shivaji. Okay. So Shivaji's expansion somehow they had to control, and the next person was appointed, that is Raja Jai Singh. So in 1664 century era, Shivaji attacked and plundered Surat. Surat was a rich port and Shivaji collected almost 1 crore rupees. English supporting the Mughals were beaten back, and when Shivaji heard the arrival of Mughals, he fled from Surat. Aurangzeb sent Raja Jai Singh against Shivaji. Now let us see, was Raja Jai Singh able to control Shivaji or control the expansion of Shivaji? Now Jai Singh captured many of Shivaji's forts. So Raja Jai Singh was also successful in capturing many forts of Shivaji. So Jai Singh captured many forts of Shivaji. Okay, and many forts like the main fort of Purandara, Raigad, etc. etc. These forts and all were captured by Raja Jai Singh, who was appointed by Aurangzeb. So Jai Singh captured many forts belonging to Shivaji. And finally, they signed a treaty. That treaty's name is Treaty of Purandar. Okay, a treaty was signed, and according to this, Shivaji had to surrender 23 forts. Shivaji had to surrender 23 forts to the Mughals. So here Mughals finally succeeded, and Shivaji signed the Treaty of Purandar, and according to the treaty, Shivaji had to surrender 23 of his forts to the Mughals, and he Shivaji can could retain 12 of his forts. So 12 forts were there with Shivaji, and 23 forts were given to the Mughals. That was according to the Treaty of Purandar. And also Shivaji agreed to pay a tribute to Aurangzeb. So Shivaji had to pay a tribute to Aurangzeb. An amount was fixed, and that tribute had to be paid to Aurangzeb by Shivaji. And also Shivaji's son Sambhaji was appointed as a mansabdar of 5000. Shivaji's son Sambhaji, he was appointed as a mansabdar of 5000. We have learnt mansabdari system, and mansabdar of 5000 means who can have that many soldiers. So he was appointed as a mansabdar. Shivaji's son Sambhaji was appointed as a mansabdar. So Jai Singh, who was appointed by Aurangzeb, captured many forts belonging to Shivaji, like Purandara, Raigad, etc. Finally, Treaty of Purandar was signed, in which Shivaji surrendered 23 forts to the Mughals, and he kept 12 forts. Shivaji also agreed to pay a tribute to Aurangzeb, and his son Sambhaji was appointed as a mansabdar of 5000. So this was how Shivaji's expansion was controlled by Aurangzeb, by the help of Jai Singh. Now Jai Singh, so all these agreement was made, and after that Jai Singh, what he did, Jai Singh, he compelled Shivaji to visit the Mughal court of Agra. So Jai Singh compelled Shivaji to visit Mughal court, or visit Aurangzeb. Mughal court, naturally Shivaji was asked to visit Aurangzeb. But when Shivaji reached there, what happened was Aurangzeb insulted him and imprisoned him. Imprisoned Shivaji. So basically it was a technique which they used to imprison Shivaji. So Jai Singh, he compelled Shivaji to visit Mughal court, but when he reached there, Aurangzeb insulted and imprisoned Shivaji. Now Shivaji was in the prison, but Shivaji, what he did, he somehow found an opportunity and he escaped. Shivaji escaped with Sambhaji. So both Shivaji and son Sambhaji both escaped in a basket of sweets. They somehow managed to get into a basket of sweets going out of the prison, and they escaped. And after escaping, Shivaji reached his kingdom, but Shivaji could not walk around like that. And what he did, he disguised as a saint. Okay, he dressed up as a saint, or like a sannyasi. Okay, disguised as a saint, he dressed up like a sannyasi, and he reached his kingdom. But later Shivaji looted Surat twice. So later what Shivaji did, he looted Surat twice. Two times he looted Surat, and all the forts which was surrendered to the Mughals, what he did, he reconquered. So that is what Shivaji is. Looted Surat twice, and he reconquered all the forts surrendered to the Mughals. Surrendered to Mughals. So what happened, once more I will tell. Jai Singh compelled Shivaji to visit Mughal court, but there Aurangzeb insulted Shivaji and imprisoned him. Shivaji somehow managed to escape with Sambhaji, and he reached his kingdom disguised as a saint, Later, Shivaji looted Surat twice and he reconquered all the forts surrendered to the Mughals, and finally Aurangzeb was not at all able to subdue him. Shivaji. So he was not able to control the power of Shivaji. So this is what happened, and these were all the conquest of Shivaji. Now let us see the final coronation of Shivaji. Coronation means crowning, okay, in which Shivaji is crowned as the king. So Shivaji's coronation. Coronation means the crowning of Shivaji. So Shivaji was crowned as king. He was crowned as king in 1674 century era. So the official coronation or crowning of Shivaji as a king happened in 1674 century era. It happened at Raigada. The function happened at Raigada with pomp and as per Vedic rituals. So all the functions happened as per Vedic rituals. So the traditional system was followed, and as per the Vedas, his crowning was happened at Raigada. And in this, after getting crowned, after getting coronated, Shivaji, he took the title Chhatrapati. So he started to be called as Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. So he took the title Chhatrapati. So finally, Shivaji died in 1680 century era. Death of Shivaji happened in 1680 century era. So Shivaji was crowned as king in 1674 century era at Raigada. As per the Vedic rituals, he took the title Chhatrapati. And finally, Shivaji's death happened in 1680 century era. So all these were the achievements of Shivaji, that is the conquests of Shivaji. We saw about the main conquest of different forts, then Shivaji and Afzal Khan, Shivaji and Aurangzeb, and then we saw his attack on Surat. So all these were the important points regarding the conquest or the achievement of Shivaji. Now just let us see the points. So attack on Surat. In 1664 century era, Shivaji attacked and plundered Surat, and he collected 1 crore rupees. The English who supported the Mughals were beaten back. When Shivaji heard the arrival of Mughal force, he fled from Surat. Aurangzeb sent Raja Jai Singh against Shivaji. Jai Singh captured many forts of Shivaji like Purandara, Raigad, etc. The Treaty of Purandar was signed in 1665 century era, and Shivaji surrendered 23 forts to the Mughals. He retained 12 forts for him. Shivaji agreed to pay a tribute to Aurangzeb, and Shivaji's son Sambhaji was appointed as Mansabdar of 5000. Jai Singh compelled Shivaji to visit the Mughal court at Agra, but Aurangzeb insulted and imprisoned him. Shivaji found an opportunity and he escaped with Sambhaji by hiding in a basket of sweets. He reached his kingdom in the disguise of a saint, and later Shivaji looted Surat twice and he conquered all the forts surrendered earlier to the Mughals. Aurangzeb was unable to subdue him. Shivaji's coronation, he was crowned as king in 1674 century era. The coronation took place at Raigada with pomp and as per Vedic rites. He took the title Chhatrapati. So I hope you have understood all the points very clearly. If you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Your likes and comments will be of a great encouragement for me to make more and more videos. I hope to see you all soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.